Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey Raptors, today is Wednesday, November 15th. I hope you guys have had a wonderful week so far. We are halfway through. Today we have advisory, so make the most of the day. Now on to the daily news.
Science Teachers by Kira S. Today I'm asking the science teachers their favorite part about teaching science.
Name?
My name is Tamara Argonani.
What grade do you teach?
I teach 6th and 8th grade science this year.
Why did you decide to be a science teacher?
I was a physics major and I started off as a math major and I switched to science because I really liked finding out an answer and it means something in the real world. And this year I'm teaching science and I'm having a lot of fun with it.
Thank you, Ms. Agavani, for all your hard work. What's your name?
Nola Mulrook.
What grade do you teach?
7th and 8th grade.
Why did you decide to be a science teacher?
I decided to be a science teacher because it is super fun. We get a change up every day on kind of what we're doing. And yeah, it's something I really enjoy.
What's your favorite part about being a science teacher?
Well, just in general, a teacher. I like helping kids. I like helping people out.
Thank you, Mr. Moray, for the amazing teaching skills. Bye, Raptors. Have a great week.
Behind the scenes with Mr. Pana.
Today I'm here with Mr. Parra. So Mr. Parra, I know you teach a lot of sensitive topics in your class. How do you make the students feel safe and comfortable in teaching?
It all starts at the beginning of the year. Team building exercises, projects to help build self-esteem in my students. Also, I want to give a shout out to my 8th grade student aides. I have a lot of student aides, but they do contribute to making this environment feel safe for the underclassmen. And so a big shout out to my student aides. First period student aides are Evan and Sasha. Second period student aide is Nathan. Fourth period student aides are Terry and Ezra, TM3 and Ezra. Johnny Manziel, AKA. Also for my fifth period class, Mr. Jordan contributes. And finally, I close it out with Talia and Crystal. They do a great job in counseling my kids when they feel blue. So big shout out to those two girls. And you know, it's a team effort.
I think that's great. Thank you. All
right. What is a safe space? A safe space is a place or environment in which a person or category of people can feel confident that they will not be exposed to discrimination, criticism, harassment, or any other emotional or physical harm. Bye, Raptors.
Admin updates with Kiwana. Today we are here with Miss O.
Hi Raptors, hope everybody's doing okay. I can't believe October has already ended and we're in November. So students, it's almost the end of the semester. Can't believe you've been at school almost one semester. So it is important that you take your classwork serious, you do your assignments, do your whatever you need to do to become a better student. Remember that everything adds up, all of those classwork, assignments, homework, they all add up to the cumulative of what grade you get at the end of it. We're going to have a lot of holidays coming. We're going to have Thanksgiving break. We have Veterans Holiday coming. So please, when you're out here, make sure you're safe. You're doing what you need to do. And I hope everybody has a great November. And
bye, Raptors.
Hi guys, I'm here with Noah, who is in 6th grade, and we are wanting feedback for your teachers. First question is, what do you want your teachers to do better?
I know.
What have your teachers done that well?
Okay.
What do your teachers want to do better so far?
They explain it to me.
Thank you. Hey guys, I'm here with
Ryan,
who is in
7th grade,
and we are wanting feedback for your teachers. First question is, what do you want your teachers to do better?
Nothing. I think teachers are great, but some teachers are a little bit too strict.
What have your teachers done? All my teachers help me do my work, and some teachers give me like extra time to work on it, which I like. What do your teachers do with that shuffle?
They help me through problems, and like if I don't know something, then they're like help me through it and give me like videos to watch.
Weird and Wacky Careers by REC. Special thanks to Ethan M. Today's odd job is animal cruelty investigator. Description: a law enforcement officer who seeks justice for animals. They investigate animal abuse and neglect cases. Also, get animals out of bad situations and homes. EDU, you need a law enforcement degree and possibly an associate's degree in zoology or veterinary science. Salary: annually they get paid $48,272 to $65,850 estimated. Sources used are Indeed.com and Salary.com. Today we interviewed an 8th grader named Levi D.
What's your name?
Levi.
And what's your grade?
8th.
Have you ever heard of an animal cruelty investigator?
No.
Alright, so what basically that is someone that investigates people that are being harmful to animals, and they try and save those animals from being harmed. Now, how do you think this job can help people or animals?
I think it'll be able to like save a lot of animals' lives, like stop people from doing bad stuff to animals.
Okay. And what do you find interesting about this job?
I think it's cool that some people want to go help, and I don't know why people do it, but yeah.
All right.
See you, Raptors.
Have a great day, Raptors.